Hi loves, so welcome back to my YouTube channel and today's episode is all about Max, our new puppy.
Yes.
So whether or not to get a puppy or not, I hope to help you guys sort of clear up that question. Boys, can you tell me how long you've been begging me for a pet?
1.5 years.
For 1.5 years they've been begging me. And what were your reasons for wanting a pet?
Company, fluffiness, cute eyes.
Company, fluffiness, cute eyes.
Yes.
Okay. That's the reason they wanted a puppy. Now, we took a really long time to decide to make this jump to get a pet because obviously with the type of lifestyle we're leading, both working parents and of course with COVID, staying at home, getting another puppy was a big decision for us. I will just definitely say that it is not easy because it's definitely like having another baby. For example, this one is teething right now and nibbling all over my fingers. This is his toy. But if you are thinking about getting a puppy, I hope this sort of helps clear up some of your questions. So the decision to get a pet was made over a year, and it literally took a year for us as a family to debate up and down, usually during dinner. Most of us in the house wanted a cat, but at the end of the day, the kids wanted a puppy. So we finally gave in and got them the puppy. There was one particular site that I kept referring to online, and I went back to it over and over again to decide which particular breed was right for us. I knew from the very beginning that a lot of responsibility would be falling on me. It's literally like having a baby all over again. It's a lifelong commitment, except this baby never really grows up. You're always going to be around to, you know, feed it, to take care of its potty, to make sure it's sleep trained, and when it's sick, the responsibility is completely on you and it's another family member. So we took a long time to come to this decision. So I would say if you're deciding on getting an animal, please, please understand why you're getting an animal and definitely be ready to take on a responsibility like if you were getting a baby into the house, because for me, that's exactly what it was. Second of all, I use this site where we can compare different breeds to understand if this particular breed was apartment friendly, would it need long walks, was it suitable for our family? Because in my life, me and Aditya are really, really super busy, and we knew that we didn't want a very large sized dog that needed a lot of exercise because we would not be able to do justice to this pet. So we made sure we got a smaller breed, apartment friendly, hypoallergenic, coating and things like that, keeping in mind everyone in the house. And also I looked at other factors in this site which might be useful to you. So I'm going to be putting, that was Max. So I'm going to be putting down the link for that site in the captions. I hope that helps you. Number two is I had a lot of questions on my Instagram about getting Max the puppy, and you guys had a lot of questions. So I'm gonna tell you guys what we did to prep for getting Max. Number one is we got pee pads. For the first 3 to 4 months when your puppy is not vaccinated, you cannot take it out because they could get infections, especially from, you know, stray dogs or, you know, anything. There is something called parvovirus as all. It's like deadly. Get to that later. Essential items that you can get before you get the puppy: pee pads and house training spray. Spray on top of the pee pad and this helps the puppy get potty trained fast. Nabber stopper sprays are great for spraying on furniture and corners where you don't want the puppy to be chewing. Kong ball, a snack ball, put the treats inside and the puppy can play with the ball thinking that he's going to get a snack soon. Soft pet toys that don't have any dangerous choking hazards like beady eyes. Treats, a kennel, and a day bed. Max can also be a little naughty at times. Like he keeps taking the toilet paper out of the bathroom or eating up his own day bed. So you all had a few questions for me. So I'm gonna go ahead and help you guys clear up any doubts. What were the parameters that we kept in mind before getting a dog? Like I said earlier, it was about, is it apartment friendly? How much exercise would this dog require? How about its expenses? Like, is it like a high grooming needs dog or is it low grooming? How obedient would it be? So the breed really does matter. So do your research beforehand. Another thing is people ask me questions about, what are the changes now in my family? I would say it has been just about one and a half months now. And honestly, it's been a lot of responsibility. If the dog falls sick, it is very emotional for the whole family. So it's like a family member being sick and it's a baby. So there's a lot of responsibility involved. Also, things that people don't tell you when you get a puppy is that for the first 6 months before the dog is vaccinated, you have to keep the dog inside your flat. So all the pee and potty is happening on those pee pads right now, and so that can be a little messy, so be prepared for that. It's not like you can immediately take the puppy out. Number two is people don't tell you how clingy puppies can be. Like Max is constantly with me, as you guys can see, all the time. If I leave this room and go to another room, he just follows us around and has to be mostly 90% of the time with me right now because I'm mama. So they can be a little clingy. And also sleep training is a real thing for puppies. So there are some sleepless nights and initially to sort of, you know, train the puppy how to sleep properly through the night. It's an alarm clock. Even like on a Sunday, if I want to sleep till 8 o'clock in the morning, it doesn't happen because the puppy wakes me up at 6:37 in the morning every day. These are things that generally people don't tell you. Also, they don't tell you how much trouble the puppy can get into. Being a puppy, you have to constantly watch it. Max has bitten through my ring light wire, some expensive items of mine. He has peed on my sofa. He has done, gone through carpets. He's gone through packages of food. He's eaten plants. I mean, during that teething stage, it's really difficult. Your furniture can get chewed off, so be prepared for that as well, because you have to constantly watch them and they are teething. So it can be quite a lot of training in the beginning.
Sit. Handshake. Good boy. Again. Handshake. Good boy.
It's a lot of hard work. I'm not gonna sugarcoat it for you guys. But in the end, we're really happy because we gave the boys a nice dog as an experience to have a pet. I think it's so important to have a pet as an experience in your childhood. And so, yeah, we're really enjoying it. Stay tuned for more.